This is the training video for learning about how to use the Smart Aligner app. We will be discussing the following items. Loading the app. Establishing a Wi-Fi connection to the tool. Starting the app and discussing the menu choices. Settings. Quick measure. Site survey. Troubleshooting. Key point review. If you have not loaded the app onto your smartphone as per the Getting Started video, you can install the free app from your App Store, Google Play for Android, or the App Store for iOS. Just search for MultiWave Smart Aligner and the app should be easily found. Select Settings icon on your smartphone and then choose Wi-Fi. Make sure that the tool is turned on. It does not need to have the arms in a valid position to establish a Wi-Fi connection to the app. You should see Smart Aligner XXXX, where XXXX is the serial number of your tool. Tap that network, and then the app should connect to your tool. Once the Wi-Fi connection is made, you can start the app. On the main menu, you will see Quick Measurement, Site Survey, and Settings. Each section will be reviewed in detail. Regardless of how you set the units on the tool, you can set the preference for the display units in your app. The display unit selection affects how the elevation and AGL distances appear on your smartphone screen and in your reports. The GPS position format can be changed. The default format is degrees minutes, decibel minutes. The format can be changed to DMS, degrees minutes seconds. This will affect how the GPS position will appear on your smartphone screen and in your reports. When you first install the app, the default setting for simulation is on. When you have simulation on, you do not need a tool reporting live information for you to experiment with the app. For example, if simulation is on, you can go to Quick Measure without the tool being on and see simulated data as if you were connected to the tool. This allows you to practice with the app indoors or evaluate the app prior to purchasing the Smart Aligner system. You will notice that simulation is written on the screen so that you do not forget to turn simulation off when at the RAD center. Once you turn simulation off, exit the app and restart it to proceed. Quick Measure is a fast way to see that the information from your tool is properly transmitting to your phone. The Quick Measure screen shows the azimuth, tilt, and roll of the antenna, as well as the GPS position, tool battery life, GPS integrity, and AGL. If you just needed a quick capture of an antenna's orientation and you didn't need a full report, Quick Measure can be very useful. You can create a quick report by selecting Screenshot. The app will display image notes, which will be appended to the image. You can include the site name, antenna sector position, and the desired target if you wish. Once you have entered all the information, select Done to create the JPEG, which is stored on your camera roll as follows. Smart Aligner is the most detailed reporting tool on the market. Its flexibility, content, and speed are second to none. We will be covering the following site survey steps. Creating a new site. Creating antenna profiles. Performing an alignment. Verifying an alignment. Adding photos to the antenna profile. Saving the file. Creating a report. Emailing a report. Once you select site survey, you need to select an existing site name or create a new one. In this case, we will create a new site. Once the site has been created, you can select that site and start adding antenna profiles to be surveyed. You could do this in advance or when you are at the RAD center. You enter the sector, position, target azimuth, target mechanical tilt, target mechanical roll, electrical tilt if required, carrier, contractor, antenna type, and serial number. You can also use the 5 user input fields for other comments if desired. Now you're ready to perform an alignment. Select a line in the bottom right corner of the screen. The measurement screen looks similar to the quick measure screen, except that it has the alignment targets and error from the targets displayed. The antenna can be adjusted until the target errors are within an acceptable range. The antenna then should be fastened in place. Once the antenna is secure from moving, you need to select Verify, which is found in the upper right corner of the screen. This process will analyze 50 azimuth tilt and roll readings and produce an azimuth summary error for you to either accept or realign. Once accepted, the app returns you to the antenna information screen. You can see your entered information in the top half of the screen and measurement data on the bottom half. If the field has blue text, you can edit it if the information is incorrect. If the data is in gray, then it is either target data or measurement data, which cannot be edited once the verification has been accepted. One of the most powerful aspects of the Smart Aligner app is that you can take up to 4 photos of your antenna survey for the closeout report. They are automatically associated to the antenna profile for reporting. Simply press the photo buttons in the bottom left corner of the screen and you can start taking photos such as line of sight, serial number, independent tilt sensor, tape drop, etc. You can see the amount of photos that you have taken in brackets. If you are using a laser or tape drop for AGL, the result can be manually entered into the AGL field. If you wish to use the True Pulse laser option, which is automatically connected to the tool, please watch the options video where that process is explained in detail. Once you are content with the antenna survey, you can use the Save button in the top right corner. If you choose Cancel in the top left corner, the program will prompt you to save your changes anyway. The next step is to create a report. Choose the report function in the lower right corner of the site antenna screen. Either manually choose which antennas to report on or choose Select All in the left lower corner of the screen. Once the proper files are selected, select Report All in the lower right corner of the screen. The app will create a PDF report with embedded photos and ask you where to email the report. If you wish to email the report from the RAD Center, remember to turn the tool off so it will drop the Wi-Fi connection and allow you to utilize your cellular service to email the report. I want to connect my phone to the tool, but I can't see the Smart Aligner tool in the network list. This could potentially happen in extreme RF environments where there are many Wi-Fi spots broadcasting. If the tool is set for automatic Wi-Fi channel selection, it can sometimes get hung up trying to analyze too many channels. To resolve this situation, use the menu on the tool to change the Wi-Fi selection from the default auto to a specific channel. You could try different channels or download a Wi-Fi analyzer app to see what the best channel would be. I have a connection, but the message says, waiting for data stream. The tool will not send out data if the arms are not in a valid position. Position the arms so that the chevrons are aligned and the tool will start to output data even if it does not have an azimuth solution yet. Please wait up to 10 seconds for the tool to output tilt and roll information from the time the arms are properly positioned. Key point review. The app needs to be installed onto your smartphone prior to ascending the tower. You need to establish a Wi-Fi connection between the app and the tool prior to running the app. Quick measure is a good way to quickly test that the data is coming to your smartphone or for doing a survey that doesn't require a lot of detail. Site survey is the proper method to create closeout quality alignment reports. Photos can be automatically embedded into your antenna survey and appear on the report. Reports can be emailed from the RAD Center, but the tool needs to be switched off in order to access the cellular network for emailing.